My name is Mark Kirchner, and I'm one of the co-owners of Studio West here in San Diego. We are an audio production facility, so we do both music production and audio for film and TV. We've got three main studios here, and we also are a school, so we offer an associate degree in recording arts, as well as individual, kind of what we call a la carte classes that might be oriented towards industry certifications and things like Pro Tools, Media Composer, and some live sound certifications and certifications in plugins and processing software. Well, I think kind of what got me started in audio was playing in a band when I was in high school. And I was the drummer in the band, and that kind of, I guess you're already carrying a bunch of gear, so somehow the PA system got lumped in with all of my equipment. And I actually ended up having more fun doing PA for other bands than playing in my band. And that eventually just kind of led to, well, if this is what it's like doing live sound, you know, let's do some recording and see what it sounds like. And that kind of got me into checking out some recording schools. Went, got a degree in recording arts, and then found my way to a little company called DigiDesign back in 1988. And they were just developing a program called Sound Tools, and that eventually turned into Pro Tools. And if you know anything about the audio world, Pro Tools is kind of a staple of our industry. It's not the highest paying job right out of school. So yeah, as far as, you know, getting into this industry, definitely having a passion, something that lights your fire, that keeps you going for the first 5 years, is something that definitely helps. And that's kind of what kept me going. Somehow or other, the stars lined up correctly, and it was a right place, right time, finding this little company called DigiDesign in the hometown that I grew up in, up near San Francisco. And I don't think that happens with everybody, but I think if you're really passionate about things, good people tend to meet other good people. And that's kind of what ignites or allows you to sort of move through this industry and excel. So it becomes sort of a stepping stone. Every little position that you have is a stepping stone to the next one. And if you go into it with that kind of mindset, then I think, you know, you're already on your way to excelling to the positions that you want to excel to. Yeah, I think as far as meaningful experiences go, for me personally, being able to have connected with this little company, DigiDesign, and having been able to spend 15 years there and watch the birth of Pro Tools, and watch the industry change, really, for me, that was hugely meaningful. But just like any industry, it's kind of a roller coaster. It's one of my favorite terms is, you know, sometimes it's up and sometimes it's down. And yeah, there are tough times in the industry, just like any career path that you might follow. For me, I think the transition probably when I kind of in my mind made that switch from music, wanting to just be recording music as much as I could every day after work, staying in the studio until 2 or 3, waking up at 6, going to work, you know, till 5 o'clock, and then going back into the studio. I probably did that for 10 years, right? And I got a lot of experience, but it wasn't until I actually started doing audio for film and TV for me that I really became super passionate about it and really sort of picked that as like, hey, instead of this is just something I do at night, this is now a career choice for me. So for me, it might have been when that kind of switch in my mind took place, decided I wanted to do audio for film and television. On the music side of the studio, we do a lot of work with KPRI locally here in San Diego, and then also a company called Slacker Radio, which is kind of like Pandora or Apple Radio. Yeah, maybe a few of the different musical artists that have been through are like the Arctic Monkeys and the Plain White Tees. Melissa Etheridge is here today. So it's kind of like a doctor's office. You never really know who's coming through the front door until you're like there watching them come in. It's pretty fun. Yeah, so if you think you're interested in audio or working in a studio, whether it's for film and TV or on the music side, it's just get your foot in the door, be persistent, do your research so you know what you're talking about, and be consistent and be reliable, because you're going to start at the bottom and you're going to work your way up. And the people that you're trying to impress were in your position at one point before, so they know how hard you have to work to get your foot in the door and to keep your foot in the door. And it's pretty easy for just about anybody in this industry to see through the BS, for lack of a better term. You know, if you're consistent, honest, hardworking, diligent, you're gonna rise to the top of any industry for the most part.